welcome to this video. This is a behind the scenes look and a tutorial kind of step by step on how to operate a drone legally and effectively within a Class D operating space. This is intended for the BGHS media class, however I decided I'm also just going to put this online as a resource. So if you like this video, please like and share it. It does help with the YouTube algorithms or whatever platform this is on. And subscribe for more content like this. I'm going to post more about behind the scenes on filmmaking, some more things like this, and just tips and tricks, as well as aviation and a whole bunch of good stuff. So that being said, this was taken by Miss Kreidel at Barry Goldwater High School, which is my alma mater. And this is something that we've wanted to do for a long time. She and I have been coordinating kind of back and forth on how to do this legally, because they are right in Deer Valley's Class Delta airspace. So I use my knowledge as a commercial pilot and flight instructor and the drone that my company Weecks Productions uses for a lot of real estate and other imaging type things. And we kind of merged the two, worked with Miss Kreidel in the media class, and put this together. So I wish I could see you guys in person for the media class watching this, but because of COVID restrictions, we had to do this off campus and park actually in an empty parking lot and across the street from the school to operate in a different area. And I'm redoing the intro because the one that we shot at the school is just full of wind and background noise. So I'm going to cut to that video here in just 1 second and just be aware that that is in the background. So I just wanted to kind of explain that. And of course, the idea behind this video is that we want everybody watching to know how to operate a drone safely, responsibly, and legally under the FAA's Part 107 rule set. So for more information on that, or if you have any questions, go to weeksproductions.com. That's W-E-E-C-K-S productions.com. Or reach out to me, and of course, for any flight training, including drones and real airplanes, danweeks.com. That being said, let's jump into it. So what we do is we get what's called a certificate of authorization, a COA, and that's what this looks like. So basically it says, attention to me, I am, this is my business number right here, for the office, which I have forwarded to my cell phone. And this COA is essentially an air traffic control clearance. This COA is valid December 8th to December 8th. So from sunrise this morning to sunset. Right now it's about noon. The sun is right overhead, so we should have some pretty decent lighting, no shadows to speak of really. And what we're gonna do is read through this COA very carefully and make sure that we're compliant. It's 3 pages. So right here, I had applied for I think 200 feet. You're allowed to go up to 400 feet. You can go up to 400 feet above the ground level, and there's two different types of altitude to talk about. There's sea level, which we call MSL, mean sea level, or AGL, which is above ground level, essentially. So if my hand is right here, this is like 5 feet AGL, but it's actually 1,528 feet MSL, based on where I'm standing, because to sea level is, you know, over 1,000 feet down. So you can go up to 400 feet above the ground, and we applied for 200 just because of Deer Valley's airspace. So what the FAA did was they actually limited us to 150 feet. The radius, I had applied for half a mile. What they did was actually limited us to 0.25. And then if we look at this map they issued, you can see that it is kind of hard to tell what that circumference actually is there. So I always do a little bit of map study too. I go to some sort of satellite view. This is the original application. Here's my map. I just printed this off my phone from Google Maps. So now we can move on to just boundaries. So we know that this apartment complex is split in half with where we can fly. So basically we're not going to cross over the street over 27th or whatever that is right there. We're not going to go south of about these apartments. So if I'm looking at this road curves. And essentially, we just want to make sure that we're staying north of Arizona Federal Credit Union. And we know that from the air, because there's no labels in real life. We're going to be looking for something that looks like that, and then just know that that's our boundary, right where the houses meet the apartment base. Again, the I-17 is a hard boundary. And what we have to do now is call air traffic control at the number provided and make sure that they know that we're about to fly. Hey, this is Dan Weecks. I've got a COA for drone activity at Barry Goldwater. Just wanted to give you guys a heads up that we're about ready to fly.
I appreciate it.
Okay, thanks. Some other notable things about this drone, it's carbon fiber. We've done a lot of work internally and externally to it. And then this lives on there. This is actually a chemical buoy. The way that a quadcopter works, You can see that these are fixed rotors. These don't move. The only thing that changes is the speed.
At this point in the video, the wind picked up and you can't really hear what I'm saying, so I'll voice it over. And that is that if these two rotors are spinning faster than the diagonal counterparts, it will yaw. If the two on the side are spinning faster than their counterparts, it will roll. And if the two in back are spinning faster than the two in front, it will pitch, just like that.
All right, so that's ready to go. We'll take the lens cap off. There's a memory card in there. We're gonna go ahead and put that down. Now we have to hook up the iPad.
Now I'm on my iPad doing a pre-flight weather briefing as well as running a checklist. And here I'm going into the Kitty Hawk app, looking at weather and making sure that the wind isn't over our minimums for the company, or maximums rather, since it is a pretty windy day. We're also making sure that the checklist is being run appropriately. There's a great video on my channel coming out pretty soon about aircraft checklists and the read and do and then do and verify methods of doing that. So we're looking at the airspace right here. We're just kind of making sure again that winds are looking good, that temperatures are looking good, everything else is looking as planned. And we are running that checklist, which is on screen right now.
It's important to first get your tablet up so you have eyes on the drone when it comes online. Next, you want to get your controller started so you're broadcasting controls so you don't have that flyaway, and then you want to start the drone. We ran our checklists, it's starting up, and then here in just a second you'll see that camera come online. So camera's online, we'll verify the overall status. You can see I'm hands off and I'm not touching the controller. The drone is auto calibrating based on that vision system on the bottom and the GPS that it's connected to. Right now it's connected to 17 GPS satellites. And that corkscrew is raising that gear. There we go, it's compensating for the wind, and then there we go. So now we're gonna do our yaw right. We'll go forward, backward, left, right. Video. We're shooting at 60 FPS right now, and now we're going to start climbing up.
Oh my god, that is so cool!
And right here,
I don't know if they can see that or not, but oh my god.
They will on the video. So now we're at 100 feet. What we're going to do is stop recording. We have that clip. We've got 76% battery, so we got to keep an eye on that. So half of flying a drone is planning your shot. So we're rolling right now. Yeah, this is a pretty good shot right into the media building, the media arts building right there. There you go, and then we'll come out of that motion. So now the aircraft is trying to land itself, so I hit cancel.
So what we're going to do is have the drone auto land. We're going to get to a safe spot, and then I'm going to give it the command to land. So I'm just going to put landing gear down, hit the auto, return to home and land, and now it's just going to land where I tell it to. I'm going to rotate the camera up so we don't get any nicks or dings from rocks, and it auto landed itself, nice and gentle.
Okay. I'm just doing a quick footage review. So this is pretty decent. We can pinch and zoom and see. It looks like we're getting some good stuff. So, all right, so now we're gonna take off. What I wanna do, I just saw kind of a cool shot, I think, is I wanna just come to like right here and then fly right through that that field goal. While I'm here, we'll go up to 150 and I'll just get kind of one of my favorite shots. This shot can be reversed. Right here, our climb is 4.3 miles an hour up. So what you want to do is anticipate. I tell my students when we're climbing in a plane, lead your climb by about 10%. Same thing here. At about 135 feet, we're going to slow down and make sure that we stick to 150.
And landing gear is locked. We got a green light. But it is important to note that when you have a necessity to walk around, you know, telephone lines or something like that and get a different vantage point, you should do that. You know, this is a many thousands of dollars investment. You have to be a licensed certified part 107 drone operator to operate a drone commercially in the US. And you know, we went through the approval process and everything like that. So rather than crashing into a telephone line
or potentially losing that line of sight, which is required, it's better just to take a 2 or 3 minute drive to the other road, you know, have somebody hold the drone, make sure that it's secure, and then just get the shot that you need in a safe manner.
Like we're going straight, but really what I'm doing with the drone is back and to the left, because that just makes more sense to my brain.
This shot, you'll notice the drone is faced one way and the camera is about 90 degrees offset to the left. That's because whichever direction I'm standing looking at the drone, for some shots like this where we have the fence, it's just better for me, and I would recommend for you to orient the drone with the way that you're standing. So if you give it a command to go to the left, it goes to the left. Whereas really for the camera that looks like it's going forward, but you're actually crabbing to the left, and it's just a little bit easier to control and keep an eye on where the drone's going.
Is this kind of what you're thinking?
Yep.
And then another shot I like to do is if we can come under the awning, maybe.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna send it the command to return to home and land. This auto defaults also, and we're rolling this whole time just in case we get any footage. So the drone is flying itself. It's auto returning based on that GPS signal and navigation tools. And what we're doing right now is I'm just kind of holding my finger here and getting a shot of this gymnasium. And we know that we're clear because we had previously set our altitude and we ran the checklist. So nice shot right over the building. And then if we needed to, here comes the drone. And if we don't know where we're at, we're disoriented or something, we are standing right here. The drone is essentially right in front of us now. And this is why you don't want to take off with people. You want a designated predetermined landing zone. So the map study is really great, you know, and now it's going to shut down the rotors and it's just going to hang out until we go get it. All right, so we're calling Deer Valley Tower again, letting them know that we're done.
Deer Valley Tower, report to land.
Hey, this is Dan Weecks with the drone over by Barry Goldover High School. We're done filming.
All right, thanks so much.
Great, thanks. Have a good one.
Nice.
Cool, and that's it. That's all you got to do. It's that simple.
Alexa, do something cool so they subscribe to my channel, please. I think she wants you guys to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching this video. It really helps if you give it a thumbs up, because then it shows it in the suggested videos for people who are trying to get their Part 107, or who maybe have their Part 107 certificate, but they're trying to figure out how to operate within the rules. For those of you in Ms. Kreidel's class, I'll be seeing you via Zoom in the next week or two. We'll be doing a conference during class to kind of chat a little bit more. So write any questions down if you have them. For everybody else, thank you guys so much for watching. It was kind of a lengthy video if your teacher didn't assign it as homework, but I do appreciate it. Leave your comments in the box below and let me know any questions that you guys have or things you want to see about drones or aviation or anything else in the future. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Oh,